You know what really grinds my gears?
Hello, everybody. Eric M and Twins 20 here. Hopefully, you're having a good day. It's October 6th, 2023. Time for another song review. And the artist that we're going to look at today is the late, great Tom Petty. Tom Petty with a slew of hits from his debut in the 70s up until his passing in 2017. This is being a top 20. This one was not an easy one to do. This is not going to only include solo songs, but it's going to include Heartbreaker songs and his a couple efforts that he did with his group Traveling Wilburys, which featured George Harrison, Roy Orbison, and Jeff Lynne from ELO, Electric Light Orchestra. And there will be another song that's thrown in here that he did as a tribute to George Harrison that he did at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame after George Harrison's passing. I'll get into that one later. But we're going to kick things off here at number 20 with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, and we're going to listen to the first song on my list at number 20, and it is Into the Great Wide Open.
Into the
So Into the Great Wide Open, the title track from his eighth studio album, released in July of 1991. Released as a single in September of 1991, the song reached number 4 on the U.S. Billboard album Rock Tracks, but stalled out at number 92 in the Hot 100. Internationally, the song peaked at number 23 on the Canadian RPM singles charts and found moderate success in Belgium and Germany. Decent song, a minor hit worldwide, including the USA. Not a very big hit here, minus the mainstream rock chart at number 4. Decent song. First single from Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, self-titled debut album. This is Breakdown. Became a top 40 hit in the U.S. and Canada. Played live. Petty sometimes incorporated Breakdown with Ray Charles' Hit the Road, Jack. A live recording of this variation appears on the Live Anthology album. Breakdown was a song written and recorded for the band's debut album. Initially, the song had lead guitarist Mike Campbell with a distinct guitar lick being played only near the end of the song. While playing it back one night, Tom Petty and Dwight Twiley, a friend of Phil Seymour's, were in the studio and Twiley enjoyed it. He suggested that the lick should be used throughout the song, and Petty obliged. At 2 a.m., he gathered the Heartbreakers to join him in re-recording the song. Their final take was 7 to 8 minutes long, but it was cut down to 2 minutes and 39 seconds on the album. Guests on the song recording include guitarist Jeff Gerard, a common collaborator with the band in the early days, and Phil Seymour, who sings backing vocals. Record World Record World called it a slow, sultry rocker dominated by guitar, with Petty's distinct vocal again standing out. It was a minor hit in the U.S. and Canada, top 40s. The best it got was 33 on the Cashbox Top 100. A decent debut song for Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers.
When she was an American girl,
from their 1976 self-titled debut album. This is American Girl. This was released as a single and did not chart in the United States, but peaked at number 40 in the UK for the week ending August 27th of 77. It was re-released in 1994 as a second single for Petty's Greatest Hits album and peaked at number 68 on the U.S. Cashbox Top 100. Despite limited chart success, American Girl has become one of Petty's most popular songs and is a staple of classic rock. It has been consistently rated as his best song, only surpassed by Free Fallin', otherwise, and one of the best rock songs of all time, and has been called more than a classic rock standard. It has also been used in several movies and television shows during a scene in which a character, much like the protagonist in the song's lyrics, is, quote, longing for something bigger than their current existence. I love this song. I love the guitar work and the vocals. This was a good song from his debut album. Third single from the 1970 album, 79 album, Damn the Torpedoes. This is Here Comes My Girl. Peaked number 59 on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 on May 24th of 1980. In a November 2003 interview with SongFacts, guitarist Mike Campbell explained the story behind Here Comes My Girl. It's very similar to Refugee. Those two were written the same week. I made some demos and Tom liked the two. Here Comes My Girl was interesting because we had the chorus and Tom wasn't sure how to do the verse. He kept trying to sing it different ways and he finally came across sort of half talking it, and that's when the song seemed to come to life. Petty remembers Campbell's chords and tune on the cassette tape and struggled with the lyrics. Bassist Ron Blair told Petty that what he had was a really good piece of music. Petty learned to use narrative in the verse, similar to Blondie or the Shangri-Las. Petty said the chorus was inspired by the Byrds. Cashbox called it a truly excellent single with a convincingly honest narrative intro and a Byrds-like hook. Record World called it a raging ballad and said that Petty's tough talk and sing vocal swells into a pretty hook. Middle of the road hit outside the United States, 59 on the Hot 100. Minor hit for him, but a damn good song. Well, it's all right, riding around in the breeze. Well, it's all right, if you live the life you please. Well, it's all right, doing the best you can. Well, it's all right, as long as you lend a hand. You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring. From the Traveling Wilburys, this was the final track from their debut album, Traveling Wilburys Volume 1. Released in October of 1988, it was also issued in January of 89 as the band's second single. The recording features all the Wilburys except Bob Dylan as lead singers. George Harrison, Jeff Lynne, and Roy Orbison sing the choruses in turn, while Petty sings the verses. The song was mainly written by George Harrison and was assigned to his publishing company. However, all five members of the group received a songwriting credit in keeping with the collaborative concept behind the Wilburys project. In the United States, the song peaked at number 63 on the Hot 100 and at number 2 on the album Rock Tracks chart. Blocked from the top spot from both Driven Out by the Fix and Working on It by Chris Rea. In the United Kingdom, the single peaked at number 52 on the UK singles chart. Absolutely love this song. Didn't get into the Wilburys till more recently. They got a couple songs on this list of mine. I absolutely love this one. Another Wilbury songs I do like is Anything You Want, but it's more of a Roy Orbison song, but it's still a damn good song. So honorable mention to Anything You Want. But this one and another one that's going to come up here shortly. Damn good songs by Traveling Wilburys. Yeah, 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 yeah. Lead single from the 1981 album Hard Promises. This is The Waiting. Song peaked at number 19 on the Hot 100 charts and number 1 on the Billboard Rock Tracks chart, where it remained for 6 consecutive weeks during the summer of 81. Song was later reissued as a B-side to the single only release of Mary Jane's Last Dance in 1993. Frontman Tom Petty explained that the song's title was inspired by a quote from fellow musician Janis Joplin, who once said of touring, quote, "I love being on stage and everything else is just waiting." He recalled, "That's where I think I got it from. Roger McGinn swears that he said it to me." Maybe he did. I don't think so. I think I got it from the Janis Joplin quote. That's where it stuck in my mind. I don't think she said the waiting is the hardest part, but it was something to that effect. Everything else is just waiting, and so that's where that came from. Record World praised Petty's vocal performance and said that, quote, "Those guitars ring, soar, and jingle jangle with enough rock and roll passion to warm the most jaded heart," end quote. Song has been covered several times from Linda Ronstadt on her 1995 album, Feels Like Home. Natalie Imbruglia covered the song for her album, Male, released in 2015. And country artist John Party covered the song for his album, Rancho Fiesta Sessions, in 2020. One of his stronger hits, middle of the road hit, but did hit number one on the Billboard Top Tracks chart. I love the song. It's a great song. Everybody's got somebody to lean on. Put your body next to mine and dream on. I've been fucked up and I've been. Second entry from the Traveling Wilburys, this is Handle With Care. Released in October of 88 as their debut single and the opening track for the album Traveling Wilburys Volume 1, the song was the first recording made by the supergroup, although it was originally intended as a bonus track on a European single by George Harrison. When he and Jeff Lynne presented the song to George Harrison's record company, the executives insisted it was too good for that purpose, a decision that resulted in the formation of the Wilburys. The song was written primarily by Harrison, although, as with all the tracks on Volume 1, the writing credits all 5 members of the band. Handled With Care was the Wilburys' most successful single, peaking at number 45 on the Hot 100 in the United States and number 2 on the album Rock Tracks chart. 21st on the UK singles chart and the top 5 hit in Australia and New Zealand. Petty and his band, the Heartbreakers, often perform Handled With Care in concert. Lynne sang it with them at the concert for George a year after Harrison's death in November 2001. Harrison's songs, Danny Harrison, sang lead on the song with Jeff Lynne's ELO during their 2019 U.S. tour. Absolutely love this song. This is my favorite Wilsbury track. What a group that was. They got some, just a powerhouse group. I mean, man, you got Dylan, Petty, Jeff Lynne, George Harrison. It's just, and Tom, oh my God, just what a group. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. Well, I love you, baby. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. Releases the first single from the album Damn the Torpedoes. This is 1979's Don't Do Me Like That. Reached number 10 on the Hot 100, becoming the band's only top 10 hit. Must be the only band, the only top 10 hit on the album. That doesn't make sense. They got tons of hits from the. That doesn't make sense. Single also peaked at number 3 in Canada and the UK despite airplay by Capital Radio. In the summer of 80, the track failed to make the top 75. I love this song. Great throwback to the 1980s. One of the best. For first single from the album Long After Dark, 1982's You Got Lucky. Song peaked at number 20 on the Billboard Hot 100, number 1 on the Top Tracks chart, where it stayed for 3 weeks at the end of the 82. Somewhat unusual for a Petty song, guitars give up the spotlight to allow synths to carry the song's main structure. You Got Lucky was written to a drum loop. I made a drum loop in my studio and put the music together. We went in the studio and actually recreated another drum loop. The drummer would actually go out and play. Then we cut the tape and tape the loop together. We ran it around the room over some mic stands and through the tape heads, and then printed that for 3 or 4 minutes, and then recorded the song over that drum loop. That was a quote from guitarist Mike Campbell about the song. Despite the song's popularity, it was initially rarely played live by the band since it was not one of Petty's personal favorites. It became more of a staple since 2014. Cashbox said that, quote, smoldering synthesizer and guitar medley set the mood, the moody scene, and that there is a sharp edge to Petty's vocal, making him sound earnest and convincing. Billboard called it a mid-tempo ballad, which has the moody intensity of a woman in love. This was only released in North America, middle of the road hit, number one on the Top Tracks list, middle of the road everywhere else. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing. Well, the good old from the Into the Great Wide Open album, this is Learning to Fly. Written in 1991 by Tom Petty and his writing partner Jeff Lynne from Electric Light Orchestra. The entire song is based on four simple chords, F, C, A minor, and G. It became a top hit for Petty and the Heartbreakers, topping the U.S. album tracks chart and peaking at number 28 on the Hot 100. Released as the first single of Into the Great Wide Open and reached number 28. It also became his most successful single on the Billboard album's rock track chart, reaching the top of the chart and remaining the summit for 6 weeks. Song was released in the UK in June of 91, debuting at 65 on the UK singles chart. 6 days later, it rose to its peak, 46 the following week, and stayed on the UK chart for 2 more weeks before leaving the top 75. Song was played and was a headline for an NBA home video documentary for the 1990 and 91 Chicago Bulls season. Middle of the Road song, one of their better songs from the 1990s. Absolutely love this song. From Stevie Nicks' debut solo album, Belladonna. This is 1981's Stop Dragging My Heart Around, recorded by Stevie Nicks and Tom Petty. Released as the first single from the album. The track is the album's only song that neither written nor co-written by Nicks. This was written by Tom Petty and Mike Campbell as a Tom Petty and the Heartbreaker song. Jimmy Iovine, who was also working for Stevie Nicks at the time, arranged for her to sing it. Petty sang with Nicks in the chorus and the bridge while his entire band played on the song. As of 2017, Stop Dragging My Heart Around remains a mainstay of Stevie Nicks' solo performances. And on July 9th of 2017, Nicks performed the song together with Petty and the Heartbreakers at the British Summertime Festival at Hyde Park in London, in what turned out to be their final performance of the song before Petty's death in October of that year. The song peaked at number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100 for 6 consecutive weeks, Nicks' biggest solo hit and the Heartbreakers' biggest hit as well. However, in the United Kingdom, the song only managed to peak at number 50. Absolutely great song. I love this. This is one of the best rock duets of all time. You don't come around here no more.
don't come around here no more. Whatever you're looking for.
Lead single from the album Southern Accents. This is 1985's Don't Come Around Here No More. On the Howard Stern Show, David A. Stewart explained that the title phrase was actually uttered by Stevie Nicks. The original inspiration of a romantic encounter producer David A. Stewart of the Eurythmics had with Stevie Nicks of Fleetwood Mac. She had broken up with Eagles singer and guitarist Joel Walsh the night before and invited Stewart to her place for a party after an early Eurythmics show in Los Angeles. Stewart did not know who she was at the time, but went anyways. When the partygoers all disappeared into a bathroom for a couple hours to snort cocaine, he decided to go upstairs to bed. He woke up at 5 a.m. to find Nicks in his room trying on Victorian clothing and described the entire scenario as very much reminiscent of Alice in Wonderland. Later that morning, when Walsh came by to find Nicks, Stewart heard Nicks throwing Walsh out, saying, "Don't come around here no more." According to Jim Levine, he went to Dave Stewart's house after an Eurythmics concert, and Dave showed him what he had of the song, not much besides the chorus and drum beat, and told him he was stuck. So Levine suggested Tom Penny finish writing it. Producer Jimmy Levine also suggested Nicks to sing it. According to Nicks, the song was originally written for her album, Rock a Little, but she declined it after Petty performed the vocals for her, feeling she could not do the song justice. According to Levine, Petty wanted to keep the song for himself ever since he was writing it. Don't Come Around Here No More is widely regarded as one of Petty's best songs. In its contemporary view of the song, Cashbox said it features a surprisingly ethereal assortment of sounds, including purely psychedelic guitars, and that Petty's gut-wrenching lead vocal is the captivating soul of the song. In 2017, Billboard ranked the song number 6 on their list of 20 greatest Tom Petty songs, and in 2020, Rolling Stone magazine ranked the song number 3 on their list of the 50 greatest Tom Petty songs of all time. The music video, absolutely wonderful. The Alice in Wonderland theme. Decent song, middle of the road hit worldwide, but one of his biggest 80s tunes of all time. Hey, baby. Lead single from his album, Full Moon Fever, his first solo album. This is I Won't Back Down. Written by Tom Petty and Jeff Lynne. Reached number 12 on the Hot 100 and topped the album Rocks Tracks chart for 5 weeks, starting the album's road to multi-platinum status. Petty recalled the recording of this song to Mojo magazine, quote, "At the session, George Harrison sang and played the guitar. I had a terrible cold that day, and George went to the store and bought a ginger root, boiled it, had me stick my head in the pot to get the ginger steam to open up my sinuses, and then I ran in and did the take." Members of the Scottish pop band Wynn reviewed the song for the May 13th, 1989 issue of British music newspaper Record Mirror. Emmanuel Chaniwa and Davey Henderson both found the title track dated. Quote, "He's definitely got old before his time, surrounding himself with his heroes," unquote. Henderson echoed, quote, "He seems to have willed himself into becoming a 40-year-old has-been," end quote. Jerry Smith, reviewer of the British newspaper magazine Music Week, called the track extremely catchy, chugging rocker, and expressed an opinion that Jeff Lynne's production is sure to leave its mark in the build-up for the release of the upcoming album. Music and Media found it rootsy, very American rock, and with country overtones, simple and charming with a nostalgic early 70s production. I absolutely agree. The song is one of his best I don't agree with the negative feedback about this song. It's a great song. Middle of the road hit. Did hit number one on the mainstream rock tracks chart. Top five in Canada on their RPM chart. One of his best and one of his first as a solo artist without the Heartbreakers. Good song.
Last dance with Mary Jane. One more time to kill the pain.
From the Wildflower album, this is Mary Jane's Last Dance. Recorded while Petty was recording the Wildflowers album, was produced by Rick Rubin, guitarist Mike Campbell, and Tom Petty. The sessions would prove to be the last to include drummer Stan Lynch before his eventual departure in 1994. The song was released as part of the Greatest Hits album in 93, rose to 14th on the Hot 100, becoming Petty's first Billboard Top 20 hit of the 90s. And also topped the Billboard Album Rocks track charts for 2 weeks. Internationally, the song reached number two in Portugal and number five in Canada. One of the best 90s tracks from Tom Petty. Absolutely love this. The music video features Kim Basinger in it. Absolutely great song.
Yeah, running down a dream that never would come to me.
Second single from Full Moon Fever, 1989's Running Down a Dream. Achieved reasonable chart success, reaching 23 both U.S. and Canada, and topped the Billboard Album Rock Tracks chart. Since garnered significant airplay on classic rock stations and lent its name to the 2007 documentary on Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. The song was co-written by Mike Campbell along with Petty and Jeff Lynne. It was a nod to Petty's musical roots. And the lyric, quote, "Me and Del were singing Little Runaway," making reference to Del Shannon and Runaway. The song uses E major as a tonic, but makes ample use of chords outside that key, such as D, G, and C major chords. Some passages use a pedal point of E in the bass while changing chords from E major to C and D major chords above it. The repeating fuzz guitar riff uses notes B. Well, we're not going to read that part. Chart listings. Number one on the rock album rock tracks chart. 23 in the Hot 100. Middle of the road everywhere else. A minor hit for Tom Petty, but one of his signature songs in his solo repertoire. And also is appearing on the... Running Down a Dream also appears on the GTA San Andreas KDST soundtrack. Second single from his Wildflower albums. This is You Wreck Me. Song did not chart on the Billboard Hot 100. It did peak at number two on the album Rock Tracks chart. Music for this song was written by Petty's longtime partner and guitarist, Mike Campbell. Petty originally wrote some words to the song and called it You Rock Me. Campbell thought the title was a little ordinary and very cliche, but the song sounded fine when they recorded it. Eventually, Petty came back and decided to change the title to You Wreck Me, and the new title changed the whole meaning of the song. It was a minor hit outside the U.S., very minor hit, one of his more weaker tracks, but still, it's a very good song. I really love the guitar work on this. He did an amazing job.
Well, let me get to the point, let's roll. Another joint, turn the radio loud. I'm too alone to be proud, and you don't know how it feels. You
lead single from the Wildflowers album. This is 1994's You Don't Know How It Feels. The track features candid lyrics describing the songwriter's desire for personal and professional autonomy. The song reached number one on the Billboard Album Rock Tracks chart, number three on the Canadian RPM charts, 13th on the Hot 100, becoming Petty's last top 40 hit in the United States. An alternate version was posthumously released on June 26th of 2020. The song peaked at number 59 on the iTunes chart. MTV and VH1 and many radio stations aired a censored version of You Don't Know How It Feels, taking the word roll out of Let's Roll Another Joint, as well as a version that played the word joint backwards. A version replacing roll with hit was also made. The music video won the MTV Video Music Award for Best Male Vocal or Video in 1995. Petty originally intended the B-side of the single Girl on LSD to appear on Wildflowers, but Warner Brothers refused it because it was too controversial. In the song, Petty sings about being in love with multiple girls on different drugs, marijuana, cocaine, LSD, beer, crystal meth, etc., etc., and coffee. In the chorus, Petty states, through ecstasy, crystal meth, and glue, I found no drug compares to you. All these pills, all this weed, I don't know just what I need. I love the song. Number one hit in the U.S., on the mainstream rock track charts, middle road success everywhere else. One of his signature 1990s songs. Full Moon album. This is 1989's Free Fallin', written by Petty and his writing partner Jeff Lynne. Features Lynne on background vocals and bass guitar. The duo wrote and recorded the single in 2 days, making it the first song completed for Full Moon Fever. This is one of Petty's most famous tracks, as well as his highest and longest charting song. Peaked at number 7 on the Hot 100 in January of 1990, becoming his third and final top 10 hit. Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers performed the song at the VMA Awards in 89 with Axl Rose and Izzy Stradlin, and at the February 2008 Super Bowl halftime show. The song is ranked at number 219 on Rolling Stone's 500 Greatest Songs of All Time. It has been featured in a slew of movies and TV shows over the years. Lou Reed selected the song as one of his picks of 1989. The song has reached number 2 on the Spotify Global Viral 50 following Petty's death in 2017. Tom Petty explained in an interview with Billboard magazine that he and Jeff Lynne were sitting around trying to come up with a song. Lynne got him to say Free Falling. The next day they recorded the song. Petty did not write the song about a specific person, but instead about what he saw during his frequent drives along Ventura Boulevard. Absolutely beautiful song. It's one of his best. This is number 3 on my list. A lot of people would say this song is his magnum opus. This song's ranked number 1 on a lot of people's lists. It's 2 on my list. As far as Petty songs, it's number 2 on my list. It's a wonderful song. Did really well. Number 1 on the mainstream rock tracks. Middle of the road everywhere else. A few top 10s here and there. No top 5s. But this is his signature 90s song from his collection. Written by George Harrison from the Beatles. This is originally from the Beatles' 1968 album, double album, The Beatles. also known as the White Album. Absolutely beautiful song. This version you're hearing was done at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame after George Harrison's death. In 2004, when George Harrison was inducted posthumously into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as a solo artist, While My Guitar Gently Leaps was played in tribute by a large band that included Tom Petty, Jeff Lynne, Steve Winwood, Harrison's son, Danny Harrison, Steve Ferrone, and Prince. The performance concluded with a highly acclaimed extended guitar solo by Prince, who was also being inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame at that time. That's this performance you just heard. And what a performance that was. Amazing. Amazing vocals by Tom Petty and Jeff Lynne. And then his George's son playing the guitar. And then Prince just took over and just shredded this shit out of the guitar and like a badass. And pretty much just at the end of the song, he flipped his guitar up in the air and a member of his entourage or somebody caught his guitar and he walked off like a badass. And just the look on the faces of everybody on stage, Tom Petty, Jeff Lynne, Winwood, and Danny Harrison, just left in awe as they're watching Prince and he's getting into it. And Tom's smiling at Prince. Prince is smiling. And it was a great performance. Go check it out if you've never seen it. Unbelievable performance and tribute to George Harrison. Number two on my list, even though it's not a Petty song, he was a part of it. It was a great performance. He did a good job on the vocals. I could have given this an honorable mention, but that version is just so iconic. And that Prince guitar work. Number two on my list. The next song, though, is the best of the bunch. Second single from Damn the Torpedoes and peaking at number 15 on the Hot 100. This is Refugee. Song co-writer Mike Campbell said Refugee is one of the first songs he wrote and recounted. I just wrote the music and handed it to Tom and he put the words all over it. And when he did, he found a way to make the chorus lift up without changing chords. In a November 2003 interview with Song Facts, Campbell described the recording sessions for Refugee. That was a hard record to make. It was a four-track that I made at my house. Tom wrote the music as it was, no changes, but it took us forever to actually cut the track. We just had a hard time getting the right feel. We must have recorded that 100 times. I remember being so frustrated with it one day. And I think this was the only time I ever did this. I just left the studio and went out of town for 2 days. I just couldn't take the pressure anymore. But then I came back, and when we regrouped, we were able to get it down on tape. Billboard described Refugee as being Petty at his best, specifically praising the gutsy rock vocal and searing guitar lines. Cashbox said it was growing interplay between guitar and organ, coupled with Petty's forceful vocals. Record World called it a perfect union of power and passion. I call it Tom Petty's magnum opus. This is his best work. Absolutely wonderful track. The music video, very gritty vintage 1980s. It was a top three hit in New Zealand. Number two in Canada on their RPM track. And then Middle of the Road elsewhere. Top 15. On the Billboard Hot 100, 11th on the Cashbox. This is my favorite Tom Petty track with Free Fallin' and close to it as far as Petty's tracks. But I love Refugee. I love cranking it in the car. It's a damn good song. That's it for this list. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you guys liked this look back at Tom Petty and his career. He is one of the greatest rockers of all time, and he is surely missed. If you like this episode, hit that like button. Leave a comment if you like. Subscribe to the channel. you'd like to help out with future projects, please visit my Patreon at patreon.com/mntwins28. You don't have to help, but any help is always greatly appreciated. Until next time, peace out.